Bert Monro is with me from Hummingbird Resources this morning. Bert, good morning. Nice to see you.
Morning. Good to see you again.
Your quarterly review out this morning. A significant period here, of course, the quarter, I suppose you could call it, with first gold pour at Yanfolila, Bert.
Yeah, absolutely. Yeah, big quarter for us. Obviously, you poured gold at the end of the year, which is obviously our biggest achievement to date. So, yeah, just a nice recap on the quarter's achievements, which is hopefully nice for everyone to be reminded of. And then a few bits on the post-period highlights as well.
Of course, you had the your gold coins from Yanfolila. When's that sale due to begin?
We said we'd try and start selling them in Q1 this year, and then certainly try and have delivery in Q2. This year. Yeah, the coins has been going really well, actually. I mean, even just today with this RNS, I think it just refreshed people. We've had a huge amount more interest just this morning. The inbox of the coin sale inbox has been filling up pretty fast, I've been told.
Brilliant. And you commissioned your carbon and leach circuit in the quarter as well?
Yeah, exactly. So, yeah, I mean, that was all part of the commissioning process leading up to gold pour. So, all of that went to plan in the quarter, and obviously, yeah, poured gold on time and on budget, the key bit of it all.
I know Cora Gold also listed on AIM in the quarter. You've got, or Hummingbird's got, just under 34% stake in Cora?
Yeah, it does, yeah. So an extremely meaningful position in Cora. It's Cora's had a really good run of late, actually. They brought out an RNS last week just saying their recent drill campaign had finished and they'd seen a lot of visible gold in the core and they were awaiting assays imminently. So I guess more exciting news hopefully to come from Cora, but I think that's been a great transaction for Hummingbird, taking some of our little explored exploration licenses that we probably weren't making full use of and adding them to a dedicated exploration team run by John Forster who have very quickly got the drill rigs turning and look to be churning out some good results. So exciting news to follow on that.
Indeed, and as far as Hummingbird's concerned, at the end of the quarter, comfortable cash-wise, around 40 million in the kitty.
Yeah, exactly. So a very strong cash position. I think that's probably quite a rare thing for a company that's come in to pour first gold as a sort of junior company, having gone through development. So I think certainly for our shareholders, hopefully it's good to know that we have that strong cash position. Ultimately, you're going through a ramp-up period to get to commercial production right now. As we announced in this RNS, we've made our first gold sales and the first gold's got to the refiner. But that said, you know, we haven't ramped up to full-scale production yet. So I think the fact that we've got an extremely strong cash position is very good.
Well, give us a bit more detail on that. How is the ramp-up going?
Yeah, very well. I think, as expected. It's been going to plan. So all ramping up since first gold pour on the 19th. I think we said in the RNS we achieved around 65% of plant capacity through the second half of December. And we've been achieving around 75% of the plant's of nameplate capacity over the course of this month. So I think very good, really. But yeah, pleased with how it's going.
And Yanfolila to be officially opened on the 14th of February, Valentine's Day.
Yeah, happy Valentine's Day for all of us. I'm sure all of our wives will be delighted that we'll be on another trip to Mali over that period. It'll certainly save us on the flower costs, I guess. But yeah, no, the president's coming to open Iron Urn, so that'll be a good day.
I mean, we've talked a lot in the past about the team on the ground, but they have really worked hard over the Christmas period and New Year to get you where you are today.
Yeah, I mean, it's a full team on site. I mean, the mine operates 24/7 around the clock, and that includes Christmas and New Year and the whole time. So, yeah, obviously, there's a certain number of our operations team. They're essentially on rotational work. So, you know, they do 6 weeks on site and then they get a couple of weeks off and then they're back for 6 weeks. So that's the nature of their roles and how they sort of structure their life. So, but yeah, no, it's literally running 24 hours a day, three shifts a day. So, yeah, it never stops.
And speaking more broadly, looking a little bit further ahead from just this current quarter that we're in, you're looking at further drilling, a bit more resource expansion at Yanfolila?
Yeah, that's definitely our expectation this year. I think one of the things we've tried to get across to everyone when we've been marketing is that Yanfolila, as it stands, is a fantastic mine, 7.5 years of mine life, over 100,000 ounces a year, a high-margin mine. But that said, we've got a huge amount of resources we haven't spent the money on to bring into reserves and make part of the mine plan. We've got well in excess of 1 million ounces of gold outside of the mine plan, but in indicated or inferred resources. So really it's about infill drilling those deposits and that ore and bringing it into reserves and then extending the mine life, which will help us maximize our value. And I think just to sort of re-emphasize that, I think a lot of companies always talk about exploration upside and how they're going to grow their mine life. A lot of that's from potential blue sky or from sort of brownfield sites, but we're talking about extensions to known deposits. We're talking about indicated resources, which is the categorization below reserves. So we've got an extremely good understanding already around those ore bodies. And we've already got, you know, theoretical ideas on conceptuals, how they'll be mined and how it'll look. So really it's about confirming up that work. So we're very hopeful over the course of this year, as well as getting into steady state nameplate operation, we'll also be able to expand the mine as well and show a much longer mine life.
Indeed. So some busy months ahead for you, Bert. You're looking forward to it?
Yeah, great. Can't wait. It's always good to be busy.
And always good to speak to you, Bert. Thanks very much.
Brilliant. Thanks a lot for your time.